1927 at St. Pete Junior College, there was nothing junior about us. We always came out the door with speed and ready to roll up our sleeves to do what needed to be done. Our title had junior in it, but we were already a senior institution. Believe that. We are proud to be Florida's first community college. We're the first state college, the first to offer baccalaureate degrees, and the list goes on and on. We strive on being number one, the most innovative, the most creative, the quickest, the fastest, and we do that because we have the best faculty in the land. I can tell you that now. Our faculty are so dedicated to our students and trying to figure out what's the secret sauce? How do we make this work? What do we do differently and better? In 1965, St. Petersburg Junior College merged with Gibbs Junior College. Gibbs Junior College was the second junior college for Negro residents, already trailblazers. And when the two came together, we made a commitment to make this county the best in the state, the best in the nation. We merged staff and students to make St. Petersburg Junior College serve not only the city of St. Petersburg, but the county, all of Pinellas County. Real proud about that, because that commitment was born through that merger. You know, we have always stood shoulder to shoulder with our community in its development. It is this legacy of educating and strengthening our community that we continue to uphold and build upon. I strongly believe in the power of education and the work we do here at St. Petersburg, because it transforms lives, it fulfills dreams, and it improves families. You've heard about my history. You've heard about where I came from, the Boca Ciega High School. We were just Bogey back then. But at Bogey, we were taught that there's nothing we can't do, regardless of our circumstance. Whether you're on free or reduced lunch, or you come from a family that can pay for lunch, the food all tastes the same. Our bellies were filled the same. The knowledge that was poured in our heads was the same. But guess what? Some of us did not get that extra support to go forward. And some of us landed in places we did not belong. At St. Petersburg College, all of our students belong. All. The beauty about what we do at St. Pete College is that we don't wait for you to be college ready. We don't wait for you to have the high SAT scores and the high, you know, ACT scores. We believe in all of that, but our mission is to bring you in where you are and take you where you want to go. That's what we're doing. And do we have challenges? Yes. Our faculty are serving as much as 30 students at one time who have various abilities, and they have to help them all gain the same competencies. It is a tough job, but it is a rewarding job when you see 2,000 students walk across the stage and say, "I made it," and know that they're going somewhere else. This May, we are going to graduate over 2,000 students at St. Petersburg College. In May, 1,300 of them have signed up to walk across the stage. I think that's worth celebrating. We look forward to our future. We have been built on a very strong foundation, and there's three pillars that we want to look at going forward. Our Board of Trustees worked very hard in December to really set up three commitments that they would like the college to make their decisions on going forward. One of those commitments would be academic excellence. See, students come to college to learn. Did y'all know that? Yeah. Now, that learning could be inside the classroom or it could be outside of the classroom. There's learning that requires you to take tests and show that you've understood the knowledge, and there's other types of learning that bring experiences to your life that you may not have ever had. Our faculty will rise to this challenge to make sure that we exhibit, exude, and offer academic excellence, where we will teach in various ways that students will learn differently. I am a visual learner. You gotta show me something for me to capture it. Some of you may be able to be like my sister. She reads it one time and she got it. I'm not that kind of learner. But if we're going to exhibit academic excellence, we have to understand who our students are, we have to understand how they learn, and then we have to be creative and innovative on how we teach and what we do in that classroom. To do that, we need to understand that many of SBC students come from 5 poverty areas of Pinellas County. You guys know that we have 5 poverty areas? Well, I know that the city of St. Pete is working on Midtown. I know there's a 2020 plan. St. Pete College has to know the whole county, because our institutions are throughout all of Pinellas County, and we're right smack dab in the middle of those poverty areas. And so we know that we have to understand and appreciate more than one city. We have to be the county's college, because our students come from the entire county and beyond. To provide academic excellence, we have to know that we have single parents out there who have worked 2 jobs. They may be sleeping in class, but it's because they're hungry. They haven't eaten. They haven't rested. There are reasons why our students struggle. But you know what? St. Pete College students, they thrive. They rise and grind. They put in the work so that they can succeed. They too have a dream. They too have desires. They too want to live a good life. Academic excellence is what they need. Because students don't graduate from financial aid. They graduate from a class. They graduate from a program. There is no one walking across the stage in May and say, "Woo, I graduated from admission." No, they're gonna say, "Professor so-and-so was so good to me." They're gonna say, "I got this program, I'm doing it. I'm going to make it. My family will live a better life. Thank you, St. Petersburg College, for believing in me. Thank you for investing in me." That's what academic excellence means to us. It is to make sure not that we just teach. It's to make sure that students are learning. See, when I grew up, when you were tall enough to reach the stove, you were cooking. Okay, that's just how Fannie Mae Jones did it, and that's how Willie Harris did it. And we were already gaining skills to help us be self-sufficient so that we know how to do what we know how to do. But here's the thing, if you have learned, you need to teach someone else how to learn. That's how this goes. That's what we do. That's how we do what we do. We ensure that our students are in a better condition by engaging us than they were before they came. We make sure they gain those competencies, those skill sets, whether it's something with an internship, or it's a shadowing opportunity, or it's real life that they're doing the work. That's our job. Academic excellence is where we're going. That is what we do. That is the crux of what we do. The second thing, we need to make sure that our students are economically mobile, that they are moving from one level to the next. We are the pathway to the middle class. That's what we do. We help people have a better life. If you have an SBC diploma certificate on your wall, you should be making money. That's how this is supposed to work. You should not be in the same situation you were before you earned that credential. So guess what? We are moving forward on improving the type of programs we offer. We're looking at certificates more to help people get jobs, and those certificates are embedded in our diplomas and degrees so students aren't starting over. We have been partnering more with Pinellas County Schools to take Pinellas Technical College credits at SPC, so students who get jobs in plumbing, somewhere that's going to fit at SPC, so that they can move. Florida and beyond to make sure that our students can get out of poverty and into prosperity. And we're doing this intentionally, purposefully, and strategically. This is not going to just happen and fall out of the sky. This is something that all of us in this room will have to invest in to make sure that residents in Pinellas County gain economic mobility, get a better job, that we decrease those 5 poverty areas, and we help people be self-sufficient. That's what this is all about. I've never heard a student say, "I can't wait to go to college to be broke." Not one time. They have a plan, and that plan ends with money in their pockets. That's where it ends. So if we are not here to help students gain economic mobility, build a pathway to middle class, help people go from poverty to prosperity, we need to close the doors. Because that's what we're here. When I went to college, did you really think that I went to college to be poor? None of us did. And we need to not treat each other that way. The other piece with economic mobility is partnering with our community. There are a lot of resources and services that we have. Some of them are duplicated. Some of them we can tweak and do better with. But SBC has to be the giver and the recipient. So that means we're in this together. Because if our students and our residents gain some sort of education, our communities are going to be better.